So that took a little bit because I couldn't get this trailer because it was still showing in the system as being fully loaded. I said, well, I looked in the back. There ain't nothing in it. So they had to go through the paperwork and find out did it deliver and when and all that. So right now we're gonna go to Gary and Love's. Hop off the reefer and get Love's coffee and then head on to the shipper. Things we took a wrong turn, we didn't. We're just coming up here to Love's, hop off the trailer since we're going to drop this trailer. Remember, we always have to have a full tank. from using the fuel item, huh? Way to go. Screwed it up for everybody. This is kind of a bad design. Do it. That's some awful good finagling there. Check that out. We snaked our way right through there. Cool beans. Okay. Trailer only. Thank you. Okay, let's go get coffee, and then we'll be right back. Everybody still here? Of course, can't tell if y'all are not. Okay, so lights on. Wow, that guy's got a big puppy dog. A lot of truck drivers have big bulldogs. Pit bulldogs, whatever they are. What do you guys, they made a row up here and this close to the fuel line. That's not even a parking spot. Get your butt to the parking spots. The Loves, this Loves washing tub is now open. Green arrow, go. Prime's just sitting there. All right, off to the shipper now. At least we're moving. And we actually have a trip that we could, like, just drive for a few days, hopefully without problems. in a hurry, ain't he? That type of stuff is what causes accidents.
Thank you.
that got flying. Geese! Geese is gonna have frozen feet. He flies his door open. Trying to wiggle through and he flies his door open. Why would you just fling your door open like that for?
Welcome to Big Rig Travels, your guide to the American highway. Broadcasting live worldwide.
Big Rig Travels is celebrating the 16th year of bringing America to you. Cheers!
Cheers, Wally! Cheers, Wally! How y'all doing? Hey, Carrie, to be a road crew member, you must kick the frog in the butt. Hey, Mark, how you doing? Leo? Thogo? Hey, Goss. Gossama. Yeah, they, No, that fire truck, he took out a car. He smacked that blue car. Flying, how you doing? Brian, howdy, howdy. Don't be mean to the frog. Bama, how you doing? John, howdy. Rick, Billy, Tom, good to see y'all. Oh, I'm so glad we're like rolling for a day or two. I know you guys hate us sitting so much. This is just a really slow time of year. It's been a really weird last year or two. Things don't go the way they normally do. So it's just weird all the way around. We try to update you guys on the blog or the X account. But sometimes things just don't work out right. We had a bad trailer yesterday, so we couldn't use it anywhere. And then we couldn't even drop it off in Gary like we did this morning because there was ice everywhere. They closed the terminal down. So, Randy, howdy. Do we have a delivery date? It's supposed to be dropped anytime the 25th, but that's a whole lot of miles in basically 2.5 days. Depends on the weather. I am thinking it'll probably be the 26th, but did we ever drive a cab over? No. Andy, how you doing? Big Lou, howdy, howdy.
Steve and Roadies, it's Sam here, watching Big Rig Travels all the way from the UK and loving it.
Hi Steve and Road Crew, Marlene STR, watching from South Louisiana. Love riding with y'all.
I hope our trailer is ready. Supposed to be ready at 8 o'clock this morning.
Howdy, Steve. This is Nathan from Leyland, Ohio. I love watching Big Rig Travels and you drive, Steve. Hi to all the road crew. Let's smash it.
Hi, Steve.
Hi, Steve. This is Bama and Little Man. You're watching from Black Hills, South Dakota. Enjoying BRT.
Howdy, Steve. This is the Super Kalen 1 from the south side of Middletown, Connecticut. Love watching Big Rig Travels and you, Steve. And I would like to say howdy to everyone out in on the road crew. So, good morning, America.
This is Eric from St. Paul, and I watch Steve on Big Rig Travels.
This is Larry in Plymouth, Minnesota, reminding everyone that when you see Big Rig Steve's like button, mash it.
John Zero, how you doing? So what's going on now? Oh, I don't know. We just picked a random driveway to sit for a while. Captain Pike, how you doing? Howdy, Albert. Yay, radishes for lunch. Thank you. Howdy, Jim. Howdy, Bill. So what makes Nightbot? How do you guys give Cheetos to Jemima? What triggers that? that's not good. Supposed to drop this off. There's a trailer there, so we'll pick the next closest spot and tell them. Snowed a little bit here, didn't it? I hope ATH is happy. They wanted me to drop my trailer in 33. And there was a green trailer like this in there.
Oh, okay, yeah.
So we put it in 24.
Oh, okay.
Just to let you know.
Okay, are you picking up something over here?
Yes.
So you gotta get your bills and stuff?
Yes.
All right, when you go in to get your bills, tell them that.
Yeah, I will.
Oh, okay.
I just try to let you guys know too.
Okay, yeah, thank you.
Yeah. All right, let's go get our bills. We'll be right back. Trailer is ready to go. We just need to get the bills first. Okay, got our bills. Whoop, whoop. Kenworth. All right, do our paperwork. Come on, truck computer, wake up. Man, you need galoshes. Oh. I can't tell if we're moving the wheels or just sliding on ice. Alright, so we're just sliding on ice. That's not. So we'll come out here, try it again. Our little onboard fifth wheel scale is not great. I don't see how it could be. This shows we're 85,000 pounds, and I know we're not. No, that's got to be incorrect. The thing is, ice messes with everything. I hope our scale is not correct. If it is, we'll be coming back here. I guess we don't need that. We need a remote control. I don't know of anything else I'm supposed to go with that. I don't know what you're talking about. It helps if I know what you're talking about. Explain. This right here, you guys told me to put my empty in 33.
Did you put anything in there?
Yeah, so I put it in 24.
Okay. I appreciate you telling me. Yep. Some drivers don't.
I hear you.
All right. And pull forward for me, please. I'll
check
that
too.
Have a nice day.
Thank you. I noticed that everything is pushed forward. When we peeked in the back door, and our scale is telling us we're gonna be like way overweight in the front. So the closest scale is Rochelle, 42 miles away. Well, Hampshire's way up there, right? I hope they didn't put everything up front, like double stack the pallets up. If we're gonna be overweight, I'm hoping that it's just like ice or something stuck in there. But when we take off, the scale changes, so it ain't ice there. I'm afraid we're gonna be way overweight in the front. Wheels are all the way forward. If you want. What is this guy doing? He's gonna go 2 miles an hour? and I hope like heck when I... I hope our scale is wrong. End up coming back this way. I thought it was kind of weird that everything was shoved up in the first half of the trailer. And from what my little scale is telling me, even if we move the fifth wheel up, which we can't do because the Starlink antenna, even that one will save it. Oh, that's right, I got a digital scale too. What's our digital scale? Oh. Yeah. Digital scale shows us way overweight. Places like this that are way out in the boonies, why don't they like have their own scale or have a little community scale or something? know, the thing is, though, when you tell a customer that they did wrong, you must do it using a CAT scale only, because they're the only ones that are certified like that. So we have to go to a CAT scale anyways. And then, we have to turn a copy of the CAT scale back to the customer and to the company, because the company is going to charge the customer for our mileage out to the nearest scale and back, the whole nine yards, so.
Thank you.
must have a new person loading this trip.
Thank you.
2 hours at the very minimum, and I bet you it's going to take them an hour or two to sort it out. I don't know, some places they go, oh, we're so sorry, let's fix it right now. Another, okay, just drop it over there in the lot, we'll get to it the next day or two. It's like, Thing is, if the driver says that he's confident it's overweight, why wouldn't you look at it? Send somebody out and look at it, because I guarantee you, if they saw it, 40,000 pounds stuffed in the first half of the trailer, they would agree that's going to be too heavy in front. You know, since they built this new America, I've not been there. Been there a couple of times when it was the old building, but since they built the automated one, we've not been there. So to see if we're going back to the shipper? Oh, look at that old cab over. PJ and the Bear used to have one like that. Oh, they made bobtail parking up here. That was a good thing to do. Look at that, they made bobtail parking. Alrighty. Alrighty, let's... see what we got going. £3,000 over in the front. Yay! We're not even gonna get fuel. Something up front, 27 in the back. There's no way you could do nothing with that. 30 pallets, and it's all in the first half of the trailer. Send a message to him. Oh, better get my paper first. Oh, that's full fire. I can run to the bathroom too. All right, I'll be right back. I knew it'd be over. I knew it. MT. Oh. All right, MT, that's for you. Oh. All right. Put the dog. All right. Bye. Okay. So let's go back to pick up. We got our. Get our thing. Where'd my glasses go? Can't leave without my glasses. Good, they're in my pocket. Alright. Alright, so we already sent a message to the boss. She just went to lunch. But that's okay. Because we gotta still do what we need to do. Okay, so let's go back to the shipper. I'm hoping that they will be able to put us right in the door, rework us. It's already 3 o'clock. Wow. But we had to come all the way out here because they won't take a driver's word for it. They want it officially documented on a CAT scale ticket. So, we got 2 copies. One for them and one for my boss. Because when this happens, this is the fault of the company, of the shipper. They will charge the company for making me drive back and forth. They'll charge the company with failure of the trip, on-time delivery, because now we're going to be late for delivery. Does that make sense? So they want everything documented, not just somebody said or somebody thinks, but we climbed onto an official scale. Official weights are 11,280 on the steers, 36,780 on the drives, 27,380 on the tandems. There's no way to account for that. The wheels are all the way forward, or the tandems are all the way forward. There's no way in the world to account for that difference. Rework, rework! Which really surprised me because I've never had trouble with this particular. That's not been, not had a problem. But, like I said,